बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम यू ऑल इन पाकिस्तान इंटरनेशनल स्कूल ताइफ वर्चुअल लर्निंग सिस्टम। टुडे इज आवर 34th वीडियो लेक्चर फॉर ग्रेड 7 स्टूडेंट्स। आई एम मिसेस रोजी इमरान, योर मैथमेटिक्स टीचर। चैप्टर नंबर 12 वी ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड इन आवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर, सो टुडे वी विल डू एक्सरसाइज 12.4। अकॉर्डिंग टू योर स्कीम ऑफ स्टडी इन 12.4 क्वेश्चन नंबर 2, 3 एंड 4 इज इंक्लूडेड एंड एक्सरसाइज 12.5 क्वेश्चन नंबर 1, 3 एंड 5 इज इंक्लूडेड एंड एक्सरसाइज 12.6 क्वेश्चन नंबर 1, 2, 3 एंड 4 इज इंक्लूडेड। सो वी विल डिस्कस ऑल दीज एक्सरसाइजेस टुडे प्लस द रिव्यू एक्सरसाइज ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 12। 12.4 question number 2, the first question which is included, that is question number 2. Find the volume of a cylinder whose height is 9.8 cm and radius of cylinder is 5.6 cm. So remember students, first of all you have to memorize the formula of volume of a cylinder, that is pi r square h. You have to memorize this formula, pi r square h. What you have given? Given that height of the cylinder 9.8 cm, radius of the cylinder 5.6 cm. Height is denoted with small h and radius is denoted with small r. Volume of the cylinder, this is the formula to calculate the volume of a cylinder, that is pi r square h. So you have to memorize this formula. Now you put value in this. Value of pi is 22/7, you know that. Value of radius is 5.6 cm, but you will take the whole square of that value. Whole square means 5.6 multiply 5.6 means that you multiply twice 5.6, okay? Then height 9.8 cm. When you multiply, when you take the square of 5.6 cm, square is that 5.6, you multiply 2 times 5.6 into 5.6, multiply 22, multiply 9.8 and then divide by 7. So you get 965.89, that will be centimeter cube. How? Here centimeter square and here centimeter, when multiply powers added, centimeter cube. So volume of a cylinder is 965.89 cm³. So this is question number 2. Now we will start question number 3. Question number 3 is, the volume of a cylinder is 311.85 cm³. Here the volume is given and height is 10 cm. Height is also given. Find the radius of the circular region of the cylinder. The radius you are going to find very easy. You will use the same formula which you use in the previous question. What you have given, first you write that, given that volume of the cylinder is 311.85 cm³. And then you have given height of the cylinder, the value of h, that is 10 cm. What you are going to find? You are going to find the radius. We know that volume of the cylinder is equal to pi r square h. We know this formula. We already studied it in previous question, pi r square h. So below each statement, we put its value, volume of the cylinder. Below we write 311.85 and pi r square h. Now you put value, pi value is 22/7, r square we don't know, h is 10 cm, is it? So you write it at this left side or right side, no problem, again it will be the same value. Now 10 multiply here, when shifted at other side it will be divided. 22 multiply here, shifted at other side, it will be divided. 7 divide here, shifted at other side, it will be multiply. So it will be like this. Look, 311.85 multiply 7 and divide by 22 into 10, 220. डिवाइड बाय 220 सेंटीमीटर स्क्वायर, सॉरी सेंटीमीटर या स्क्वायर, बिकॉज द सेंटीमीटर क्यूब डिवाइडेड बाय सेंटीमीटर, सो सेंटीमीटर स्क्वायर वी गेट. नाउ वी वांट टू फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ आर. Okay, so when we calculate, multiply by 7 divided by 220, we get this. We want r, not r square. So to remove the square, what will we do? We taking square root on both side. When we take square root on both sides, square and square root cancel, and under root 9.9225 centimeter square. So we get 3.15 centimeter. So this is the answer. Again, I'm going to repeat it. You have given that the volume of the cylinder is this, height of the cylinder is this. You have to find the radius. Formula, we know that volume of the cylinder is pi r square h. So volume of cylinder, we put the volume value, and pi r square h, we put the value of pi r square as it is, because we don't know about the radius. H, we put its value. Now 10 into 22, that is 220. It multiply here in left hand side. When shifted at right hand side, it will be divide. 7 divide here. When shifted at other side, it will be multiply. Now 7 multiply with this value and divide by 220, we get this. So this is radius square. We want to find the radius. So what will we do? We taking square root on both sides. When we take square root and square remove. So we get r, and under root of 9.9225, we get 3.15 centimeter. This is question number 3, which is included in 12.4. Now question number, last question of this exercise, question number 4. Here you have given the radius of the cylinder is 7 centimeter and its volume is 2,233 centimeter cube. Find the height of the cylinder. Just like previous question, we use the same formula. We put the known value, and for unknown value, we find it. How? First of all, we write given that volume of the cylinder 2,233 centimeter cube, and radius of the cylinder, that is 7 centimeter. Height we are going to find. We know that volume of the cylinder is equal to pi r square h. Volume of the cylinder is pi r square h. In place of volume of cylinder, we put its value. In place of pi, 22/7. In place of r, 7 centimeter square. H we don't know, so we write h as it is. Like this, pi r square h is equal to this. So pi is 22/7, r square is 7 centimeter square. H we don't know, so we write as it is. Now we calculate here. Look, 7 7s are 49. 49 multiply 22, we get 154. So 154 divide by here, and 7 is, look, 7 centimeter square. So 7, 2 times present, 1 time cancel with this denominator, 1 time left. So 7 multiply 22, we get 154. 154 multiply here, shifted at other side, divide. So we get h value is 14.5 centimeter. So this is 12.4. I hope you will understand it. If any difficulty, you can ask in Zoom meeting class. Now come to the next exercise, that is 12.5. In 12.5, you have question number 1, 3 and 5. So I'll discuss 2 questions and 1 question I'll give you homework. So question number 1 is, the diameter of the wheel of Irfan's bike is 0.7 meter. The diameter of the wheel is given. You know that the wheel is in circular form. So diameter means the line which is passing from the center. That is 0.7 meter. If you want to find the radius, so 0.7 divided by 2. The wheel completes 1800 revolution when he reached home from office. Means that the wheel rotate how many times? 1800 times when he reached home from office. Find the distance between Irfan house and the office. Means that the total distance you are going to find that in 1800 revolution, how much distance it will cover. So given that diameter z 0.7 meter and circumference, you know that if you have given radius, so you write 2 pi r because diameter is equal to 2 r. So if you have given diameter, so in place of 2 r you write just d, because you know that circumference is 2 pi r and diameter is equal to 2 r. So in place of 2 r you can write d. Okay, so circumference you find that is pi is 22 by 7 and d is given 0.7 meter. So multiply with 22, divide by 7, you get 2.2 meter. Clear? So in one revolution the distance covered 2.2 meter. Means that in one revolution when the wheel rotate one time, so it cover when complete rotate it cover 2.2 meter. So now you have to find in 1800 revolution it travel how much. So 2.2 meter multiply, because one revolution you know that 1800 revolution you are going to find. So 2.2 multiply 1800, so you get 3960 meter. Means that 3 kilometer and 960 meter. Okay, so means that the distance between Irfan house and office is 3690 meter. Clear? Now again, look, diameter is given. Therefore, to find the circumference, we use instead of 2 pi r, we use pi d, because 2 r is equal to d diameter. So 22 by 7 into 0.7, 2.2 meter. 2.2 meter is the distance which the bike cover in one revolution. You are going to find in 1800 revolution. So multiply with the distance which cover in one revolution. So you will get the total distance. I hope if you will understand it. Now come to the question number 3 is your homework. The length of minute hand of a watch is 1.75 centimeter. Find in how many hours the pointer of minute hand will move to cover 165 centimeter. So you will solve it by yourself. Now come to the question number 5. Question number 3 is your homework. The radius of a circular garden is 24.5 meter. This is the radius, means that you have a garden and garden is in shape of circle. Okay, so its radius is, means from the center to the boundary its distance is 24.5 meter. Find the cost of fencing the garden at the rate of rupees 175 per meter. Means that the cost outside the boundary of a circular circular area is, you know that the boundary is its circumference. So first you find the circumference, then the cost. You can easily find it, because for 1 meter you have given that the cost is 175 rupees. So when you find the circumference, so the total circumference multiply with this price, so you will get the cost of the fencing. So what you have given? You have given radius of a circular garden, that is 24.5 meter. So you have to find the circumference of the garden. Here I use 2 pi r. Look for circumference, because the radius is given. If diameter given, then simply you write pi d. Clear? So 2 pi r. Now you put value in this. 2 pi is 22 by 7 and r is 24.5. So when with your calculator you calculate 24.5 multiply with 22 multiply with 2 and then the whole answer divide by 7, so you will get 154 meter. Clear? What you get? 154 meter. So 154 meter you get, you are going to find the cost of fencing. Fencing means that the outside boundary, if you use fencing in the outside boundary, on the circumference, outside boundary means the circumference of a garden. So what will be the cost? So cost of fencing, not flooring, sorry. Cost of fencing. Here you write cost of fencing. Cost of fencing, you can easily find it. Yes, you have fine 154 meter. Cost of fencing 175 rupees per meter. So 175 multiply 154. So when you multiply, you get 26,950 rupees. When you multiply these two, so the total cost is that much rupees, 26,950 rupees. So this is the last question of exercise 12.5. Now we are going to start exercise 12.6. So 12.6 is first question. In 12.6, you have question number 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay. So one question I will give you homework, and three I'll discuss it here in this video lecture. So a cylindrical wooden piece is 19.4 centimeter long. Find the surface area of wooden piece if its diameter is 14 centimeter. What you have given? You have given that the box is, wooden piece is cylindrical, means in shape of cylinder. Okay. Its length is given 19.4 centimeter, and you have to find the surface area of the wooden piece if its diameter is also given 14 centimeter. So length of the cylindrical wooden piece is 19.4 centimeter. Its diameter is 14 centimeter. So its radius will be, you know, the diameter divided by 2. You will get the radius, 14 divided by 2, 7 centimeter. Surface area of a cylinder. So this is the formula to find the surface area of a cylinder. You will memorize this formula to calculate the surface area of the cylinder. That is 2 pi r into h plus r, okay, or r plus h or h plus r, means that the bracket you solve first and then the outside value. So you put value in this 2 as it is, value of pi 22/7, value of r 7 centimeter, bracket start, value of r 7 centimeter, value of h 19.4 centimeter. So first you add these two, 7 plus 19.4 centimeter, then you do the outside work. Look, 2 into 22, 44, 7 cancel with 7, and here 7 centimeter plus 19.4 centimeter, 26.4 centimeter. Now this 44 centimeter you will multiply with 26.4 centimeter, you get 1161.6 centimeter square. So this is the surface area of the wooden piece. Again, length of the cylindrical wooden piece is given. So means that length means the value of its cylindrical shape. So the length represent h. H is 19.4. Its diameter given 14 centimeter. But you know that in surface area we need radius. So to find the radius, diameter divided by 2. So that is 7 centimeter. This formula, surface area of a cylinder, this you will memorize, 2 pi r. You can write it r plus h or h plus r. Doesn't matter that you write h plus and r after that, and r first and h after that. Now you put value in this, 7 cancel with 7, 22 into 2, 44, 7 plus 19.4, 26.4. You multiply them, you will get the required surface area of the cylinder wooden piece. Question number two is a tin pack of a soft drink is 10 centimeter long. Again, look, if it is a soft drink tin, you know that again it's a cylindrical shape. So if they say that long, so means that this is the value of h, 10 centimeter, and the radius of the tin pack is 3.3 centimeter. Find the surface area of the tin pack. Very easy. Surface area formula, you know that 2 pi r into r plus h. So you just put value of h, 10 centimeter, value of r, 3.3. So you will get the answer. Length h is 10 centimeter, radius r is 3.3 centimeter, surface area of 10, same formula which we use in previous question, 2 pi r, r plus h. Put value, pi value 22 by 7, r value 3.3 centimeter, bracket start, r value 3.3 plus h value 10 centimeter. Now, this 3.3 multiply with 22 and multiply with 2 and divide by 7, and this 3.3 plus 10, so that is 13.3. So this 13.3 multiply with this, so we get the required answer 275.88 centimeter square. Next, question number 3. Question number 3 is a circular pillar of 22.5 centimeter radius is, if it is a pillar, again it's cylindrical shape from base to height. So means that the length which is given, that will be the value of h. A circular pillar of 22.5 centimeter radius, radius is given, 6.3 meter long. So means that the h value given, calculate the surface area of the pillar. Now student, you can check this value is given in centimeter and this value is given in meter. So you must convert in same unit. So this meter, you can convert it in centimeter by, you know that in 1 meter, you have 100 centimeters. So when you calculate such type of values, all the value which is given, the value of h, the value of r, it should be in the same unit. So the 6.3 meter, you convert in centimeter. In 1 meter, you know that 100 centimeter. So 6.3, you multiply with 100. So what you have given, radius of the pillar, that is 22.5 centimeter, and then its length 6.3 meter. So you convert this length into centimeter, 6.3 multiply 100. So you get 630 centimeter, 6.3 multiply 100 centimeter. So you get 630 centimeter. We convert meter into centimeter. Now you put the, you find the surface area of the cylinder. Again, the same formula, 2 pi r, h plus r or r plus h. So you put value in this, 2 pi value 22 by 7, r value 22.5 centimeter, h value 630 plus 22.5. So here 22.5 multiply 22 multiply 2 divided by 7 and multiply with 630 plus 22.5. So you get what? First you calculate this, you get 141.43 centimeter, and when you get add 630 with 22.5, you get 652.5 centimeter. Now you multiply these two values, so you will get the surface area, that is 92,282.1429 centimeter square. The next question, question number four is your homework. In question number four, you have given a cylindrical chemical drum is 220.5 centimeter long, means h value is given, and the radius of the drum is 42 centimeter, means that the r value given. Calculate the cost of painting the drum. So first you find the surface area. When you get the surface area, that you multiply with, for cost, that you multiply with 0.15, so you will get the answer. I hope you will understand. Question number four, again I'm going to repeat. You have given length, means the value of h, and radius, the value of r. You will calculate the surface area just like this. In this formula, you put the value and you get the surface area. To find the cost of painting the drum, the surface area which you get, this value, that you multiply with 0.15, because it's given 0.15. Multiply with 0.15, so you get the cost. So I already gave you a hint for the homework. Now come to the review exercise. In review exercise, question number 2 and question number 3 is included. So question number 3 is your homework. You will do it by yourself. Fill in the blanks. I am going to discuss it here. And the MCQs, you will try to do it by yourself. First is, the dash of a circle is the measure of its close curve. The dash of a circle is the measurement of its close curve. Close curve means outside boundary. That is circumference. That is circumference. Second is, two circular regions of a cylinder are dashed to each other. If you have a two circular region, so that will be parallel to each other. Number 3, the length of the dash is called the height of a cylinder. So means that the length of the curved surface is the height of the cylinder. The length of the curved surface is the height of the cylinder. The ratio between circumference diameter of a circle is denoted by its symbol. This ratio, circumference and diameter of a circle, is pi. This ratio is pi. Surface area of a cylinder is equal to area of the curved surface plus area of two circles. Area of the curved surface plus area of two circles. So these are the fill in the blanks. Now come to the homework. 12.5, question number 3. Only 2 questions I gave you homework. Exercise 12.6. Question number 4 and review exercise 12, question number 3. So these are your homework. Very easy topic. I hope you will understand it. After this, inshallah, we will start chapter number 13. And chapter number 13 is the last chapter of your syllabus. Okay. So in this, we use 2 formulas. One is the volume of the cylinder, that is pi r square h. Next is the surface area of the cylinder, that is 2 pi r into r plus h. So we use these formulas. I hope you will understand it. If any difficulty, you can ask in Zoom meeting class. Take care. Allah Hafiz.